Hey, what's going on? What's going on, all my YouTube family? Hey, first of all, I just want to say thank you to all my new subscribers. I appreciate you guys, checking out my channel and following me. I definitely want to say again, thank you so much. And if you have a channel with content, and I have not went back and subscribed back to your channel, just send me a message or whatever. It was definitely nothing on purpose. Sometimes I get caught up with a lot of, with a lot of stuff, what I be doing with my truck and everything, as far as maintenance and everything. So it definitely was not anything on purpose. So if I forgot to subscribe back to your channel or whatever, just check, send me a message or whatever, and I'll be sure to subscribe back to you. If you're trying to grow a channel or something like that, you got content, you're trying to grow a channel, just message me and I definitely subscribe back to your channel, okay? Other than that, y'all have been kind of laying low a little bit. Been off for a couple of days, about 10 days actually. I'm back in my truck. I'm not actually on the road yet. I'm just kind of getting my truck back in shape. I had to go ahead and renew my tags and all that stuff while I was home. And, just kind of been relaxing a little bit. The flower season pretty much died down because once it gets real, real hot, the flowers don't do like they normally do. It kind of goes down. And it kind of got hot a little bit out of season. It kind of got hot a little bit before the normal high temperatures. Let's put it that way. All right. So, anyway, so I'll be getting back out onto the road probably tomorrow. All right. So today, I just got it cranked up and everything. I've been changing a few things. I know I had to change the that output seal on the top of the steering gearbox, right where the steering wheel shaft comes down to the top of the steering gearbox. Right in the top, you got that output seal right there. Sometimes it can start leaking out the power steering fluid. So I changed that seal. Should have recorded it, but I think there's a couple of videos already on YouTube about how to change that from the guys at TRW who actually make the steering gearboxes. So they got the actual professional way to do it. I think there's another video on, what is that channel? OTR or something like that. It's another channel. But anyway, getting ready to go check on my trailer, on my reefer trailer. Like I said, it's been sitting like 10 days also. So I'm getting ready to go out there, pre-trip it, make sure everything's good. I got to do a little bit of work on my air chute in the inside. You guys that pull reefer trailers, y'all know what the air chute is, that go down the top inside of the trailer. So I got to go check on that. It got banged around a little bit while I was pulling those plants, while them pushing those racks and stuff against the back. So they kind of banged up my air chute a little bit. So I'm getting ready to go check that and make sure, if I do have any little holes in it, I got to make sure I get those holes repaired before you start pulling certain product, because certain shippers will reject your trailer if you have holes in the air chute that's up close to the front, because the way it's supposed to work is your air is supposed to come out of that reefer unit, go along the air chute, go to the back doors, come out the back of the air chute at the back doors, hit the back doors of your trailer, go down to the floor, and run through those grooves that's in the bottom of a trailer floor, run through those grooves and cool the product, and it makes a continuous loop around the product. So that's the way it's supposed to work. When you got holes and stuff in your air chute, some of the air and stuff will hit the product before it makes it all the way back to the back of the trailer. Sometimes that can cause top freezing on certain product or whatever. So sometimes shippers will reject the trailer if you have holes and stuff in your air chute. So I'm just going to make sure my chute is, performing the way it's supposed to perform. So when I do put product in the trailer of a sensitive nature, I won't have any issues with claims and stuff like that, rejections on the other end or rejected trailers on the front end. All right, y'all. So I didn't mean to make the video that long, but I just want to say again, thanks to all my new subs. I'm almost at 300, y'all. Yeah, right. Some big number, right? But anyway, it's good for me, because I didn't try, I'm not trying to be no big, all this here. If I do, great. If not, no big deal. I just share what I share, all right? So again, one love. I'm about to get out of here and go do what I got to do. Again, thank you guys for checking me out. And the ones that are not subscribed or whatever, hey, you know what I'm saying? Subscribe to me, share the video, thumbs it up, thumbs down, or whatever. Whatever you're going to do. But like I told you before, don't thumbs down my shit. Because if you do, I'm going to fuck you up. Nah. But anyway, that's your boy. We'll holler at y'all later on. Y'all have a great day. Today is Sunday. Y'all have a great day, man. We'll holler at y'all later, all right? Peace.